Hello, and thank you all for joining us. My name is Fran Spreer Albert, and I'm the Chief Operating Officer and Chief Financial Officer here at Albany Med.
And I'm Chris Cuchet, the System Chief Information Officer. We're here to update you on our progress, vision, and guiding principles for a transformational effort for our system, a unified electronic medical record, and enterprise resource planning process.
You have all heard about this exciting effort that is for all of us. It will elevate the way we deliver care to all of our communities, and it will bring us closer together as one system.
Epic has been selected as our EMR and Workday as our ERP. Both of these applications are widely used and respected by many other health systems.
It will streamline our work and enhance access to our care everywhere that we provide it. Now, I am very happy to introduce two representatives from our consulting partners, Chartis and Nordic. Chartis has joined us to help us with creating the governance structure, as well as creating alignment across our entire system. And Nordic has joined us to help with all of those detail builds and all of those various work streams that we need to create. So let me introduce John McCullough from Chartis. Thank you, John, for being here today. And Andy Adams from Nordic. And thank you, Andy, for joining us today. Also, we are very proud to unveil the theme for this most important effort, Albany Med Health System, Care One. Care One. It puts care first for our patients, our colleagues, and our entire system. We are one team, and this is one very important effort. This is our number one priority as we integrate as a system.
Now that you've met the team that we'll be working with, we'd like to give you an overview of why this project is so critical for not only us, but our patients.
And we're going to start by outlining our vision and our guiding principles that we have all agreed upon as a system from every single campus. Our vision is to enhance the region's patient care and community-centered services and elevate the experience of our team by building an integrated clinical and business platform together. Our guiding principles will guide our shared goals. We are patient and workforce-centered. We view decisions through the lens of the patient and the team, which includes our providers, administrators, care team, and students, by streamlining workflows, usability, and access. Focus and priority. We focus and place the program as the top priority as we integrate the health system through 2025. Effective decision-making. We will assure timely, definitive, inclusive, and informed decision-making, championing standard work and best practice. We will not revisit well-made decisions. Systemness. We will standardize and support systemness while maintaining local culture. We will elevate our performance and care for all in our region, harnessing our individual strengths. And of course, fiscal responsibility. We will be financially prudent and disciplined with decisions that have a financial impact while assuring adherence to the program timeline.
In addition to our guiding principles, we're also committed to the following. Number one, an integrated platform. Epic is a single integrated EMR and Workday is a single integrated ERP, and we will maximize all of the selected vendor functionality and workflows. Number two, leadership and collaboration. We assure that the program is operationally led, clinically driven, and supported by IT. Collaboration is key, and together we will be inclusive and respectful to bring our vision to reality. Three, data integrity. We will prioritize data standardization across the health system and elevate data and analytics to deliver accelerated, accurate reporting. And finally, transparency. We will provide frequent, targeted communication to all stakeholders and ensure open and transparent information sharing. Communication is the responsibility of all shareholders.
And now a few questions for our partners. Andy, I'll start with you. From your perspective, what exactly will the EMR do for our system and how will it be used?
Sure. Well, before I begin, let me just say that you are in good company. Most of the largest and most successful academic medical centers and community hospitals across New York and really across America have selected and successfully implemented Epic over the last few decades, Epic is a best-in-class tool that's really going to transform care delivery and improve patient outcomes. Epic is your new EMR. It's an electronic version of the patient's medical history. It includes one integrated version of all the clinical information about the patient over all episodes of care, regardless of the setting of care. And it's going to include a lot of important information that's going, and Epic will then access, automate the access to information and will streamline the clinician's workflow. And then the EMR will also be used to enable evidence-based medicine, decision support, quality management, and outcomes reporting. And so you can imagine how having one consolidated view of the patient's history in one place at your fingertips will reduce errors of omission and improve patient outcomes across our communities. And then did I mention for patients who travel, their Epic record is transportable so that you can see where they've been provided care elsewhere, and you can share care provided by AMHS with others. And then Epic is also used to schedule, register, and bill for services provided to patients, so all patient access and revenue cycle processes are in scope.
Fantastic. And John, can I ask you a similar question for the ERP and let you know that that acronym is a little more confusing to our broader workforce than perhaps the EMR? So if you could shed some light on that.
Absolutely. You know, much like Andy described with the EMR, you're in great company with the Enterprise Resource Planning application, or ERP, and moving the workday. As you think about the EMR as the system of record for the health side, the ERP is the system of record for the business applications and the business side of the operations. And in this case, we'll be facilitating a transformation for the finance function. So you think about general accounting, banking, treasury, et cetera. It'll also be a system of record for supply chain. So one supply chain function across the entire organization when it comes to technology. And you think about that processes like procurement, inventory, contracts, and sourcing. IT also will benefit from the transformation going on to a single ERP as well. There's a lot of improvement in technology and tools for IT around interfaces, data conversions, security, mobile tools like handhelds, and improvements around reporting as well.
Fantastic. And is there any other platform you would compare Workday to, John? A platform maybe that people use in their daily lives, like Amazon to place orders and so forth. Does it look a little more like that?
Yeah, I think that's a great question. You know, you have some similarity to that with the Workday platform because you actually have it in part of your operations today. So when you think about HCM and payroll within the Albany campus, we're actually going to be building onto that platform and expanding it. And Amazon's a great experience, the shopping experience, the mobile experience, the experience with having different types of tools and systems to help you buy smarter and spend smarter. So that's a great example and a great comparison.
Fantastic. Andy, a question for you. Our system is still a relatively new system, high energy, and we're very excited to be working on this project together. But have you ever worked with a system like ours that's still in its early years of formation and development?
Absolutely. We've worked with many similar organizations that were coming together as a system during an EMR implementation. So for example, Nordica supported organizations that have implemented enterprise technology as part of a merger or an acquisition. And in those cases, as you can imagine, multiple hospitals and physician groups were coming together to transition to a single EMR platform as they integrated. Now, Albany Med Health System situation is different, of course, but there are a lot of parallels. This can be done and it can be done very successfully, but the project will require leaders, clinicians, staff, from each organization and campus to dedicate time and effort and to be open to change, sometimes significant change, because in many cases, the best answer for the broader system may be a new standard approach or workflow.
Chris, do you have some questions you'd like to add?
I do. I think one of the things that everybody in our system really wants to know is who's going to be involved, who's going to be active in this project across all four campuses. And I'll ask that for both Andy and John, whoever wants to jump in.
Yeah, I'll start. You know, everyone is the way to answer that question. I mean, it's really a multidisciplinary, multi-campus multi-leader effort. When you think about all of your CEOs, CFOs, all of your leaders, leaders across multiple disciplines, vendor partners, and we obviously will have Workday and Epic there at the table as well. And each of you, you know, it's really going to take everyone that touches the system and their participation and an active engagement to really make this work.
Thanks, John. You know, Andy, maybe you can answer one of these questions in terms of how is it seen that decisions are going to be made? There are going to be thousands of decisions that we're going to have to make as a business, both on the EMR and on the ERP projects. How does that look? How will that look in terms of all those decisions that have to get made from, you know, from the large system level decisions down to the smallest detail of workflow?
Absolutely. So there is already a governance structure that is being stood up that includes advisory councils and work groups and sponsors and even the cabinet involved. And across all of those groups, there's representation and involvement from every single campus, because it's important that every campus have a voice and that the perspectives and unique needs of each community and organization are well understood and considered as we design these things. And it's important to know too that as we move through this program, the vast majority of decisions are going to be made by those work groups. Those work groups are going to be constituted of by folks who are closest to the work that happens each and every day, whether it's in the patient care setting or in business process settings. And most of the decisions will be made there. And in some cases, decisions may need to be escalated to those advisory councils and other groups that I mentioned.
Thank you so much, Andy. John, a question for you with respect to the ERP. What is our general timeline?
Yeah, General, we actually have started a pre-planning now. So since January, we've been engaged with Workday on just the get ready activities to be ready for kickoff. We'll be kicking off the project on March the 1st, so very, very soon. And the project is slated to go live on July 1st of 2023.
Fantastic. And same question for you, Andy.
Yeah, absolutely. EMR is on a slightly different timeline than ERP, but we've already begun the journey for EMR, and it will continue for the next 3 years. So we're currently in the EMR planning phase, which involves assembling the leadership team, putting in the governance structure that we talked about, understanding current processes and tools. Pretty soon we'll begin to assemble and train the core team that over the next 6 months or so that's going to drive the Epic design activities. And then those Epic design activities will be launched in September, and that's where many, many individuals from across the organization will become much more heavily involved. The first go live for Epic is scheduled for Q1 of 2024, and the second go live for Q3 of 2024.
This is such exciting news, such exciting progress for the system. Albany Med Health System Care One has officially launched. Thank you all so much for being here today. I want to say that there was a group of us across all four campuses who had to make two very, very important initial decisions. Who would our vendor partners be? Epic and Workday, world class, top in their market segment. And who would our consulting partners be? Chartis and Nordic. And we couldn't be happier with that very important decision we have made. You have gotten us off to an absolutely rock solid start, and we are excited for what's to come over the next few years. So thank you, everybody, for listening in today, and much more news to come on the internet, via video, and other notices about this most important project. Take care.